Much is happening now that will delight you. Truly, enormous changes are taking place that will permanently alter the illusory world in which you experience being human. And these changes are for the good of all on earth, yes, even those who appear to be wedded to the dark. You have been praying for this and intending for it to happen. Your collective intent has now become unalterable, and it will be maintained. Your love and your loving intentions have changed the world. There is no going back to the old ways of deception, betrayal, and conflict. You, all of humanity, can only move forwards further into love. It is your natural state, you have recognized it, and it is drawing you onwards, forwards, ever closer to your heavenly destiny, because you were created there in infinite joy to experience and enjoy that state eternally, and so you will return there. The nightmare, the separated state in which you have been experiencing so much suffering, seemingly for eons, is dissolving. You sense this, you feel this, as your unaddressed issues rise to the surface of your conscious awareness to be acknowledged and released. You may find this unsettling, disturbing, and be tempted to seek distraction. Do not face these dark energies arising within you, but do not identify with them or engage with them, just let them be. Observe them, realize that they are not you and let them flow through. To engage with them or identify with them gives them some of your energy, enabling them to fight with you and suggest that you are not good enough, that you are unworthy, thus leaving you feeling drained and depressed. Every sentient being that God has ever created has his or her own individual energy field created at that same moment of creation, while at the same time remaining one eternally with him. The field of oneness, God's divine energy field, can never in any way be diminished, and you can never be separated from it, but you can allow yours to be diminished by choosing to engage with the dark or misguided ones who are lost and terrified in the illusion, and who need to feed on the energy of others because they feel themselves utterly separated from their own energy fields, with their very existence dangerously threatened. Your individual energy fields are the life force that runs through your bodies. When you chose to experience separation from your divine source, you chose to experience your energy fields as separated from the divine one. Then you found that you could hide from the light and seemingly create the dark. The dark is but an absence of light, but that absence is terrifying and it seems to have immense power. The reason that it appears to be so powerful is because you, having apparently separated your individual energy field from God's energy field, feel extremely weakened. The light has, as it were, gone out, and the darkness appears all enveloping. Of course, the light has not gone out, it is just that your awareness of it weakens when you focus on the dark. Be cognizant of the dark, send it your love, your compassion, your forgiveness, but do not engage with it or mistake it for yourselves. It is unreal and you are real. The love, compassion, and forgiveness you send to it assists others who are seemingly deeply immersed in it, shows them that there is light at the end of the tunnel, and encourages them to move towards it. As you have been told so often, your loving intentions are enormously powerful, even when you are feeling low or depressed. Those feelings are just passing through, just like your unaddressed issues mentioned above, so do not engage with them as that slows their passing. Be aware of those feelings, acknowledge them, they may be as a result of painful events in your past that still have a hold on you. Offer them love and comfort rather than dismissing or denying them, and thus allow inner healing to occur. Peace will follow. Your nature, being love, is therefore also peace. When you worry about problems or issues that appear important to you, you shut yourselves off from peace, because peace is free of worry. Frequently, when you worry, the issues that you are worrying about seem to grow in importance, taking up more space in your minds, and leaving less room for peace, which at its simplest is just freedom from worry. Practical rational thought about how to deal with issues makes sense, and that, for instance, includes accepting that perhaps in this moment, you do not have all the information you need to deal with a particular issue. Instead of worrying while you wait, move on to another issue for which you do have information, or take time to smell the roses, or perhaps, this being January, play in the snow. Doing something that you enjoy, without guilt, is very healing, because it demonstrates to you that you care for yourselves, and it will put smiles on your faces. And smiling intensifies your enjoyment, honoring you and helping to dissolve your worries. To honor and respect yourselves is very important. God created you as perfect beings, and He always honors and respects you, so follow His example. As humans, you are limited in your awareness, in your intelligence, in your understanding, and so life is often very challenging for you. You make mistakes, you say or do things that are unloving, unkind, even intentionally so, and you either feel bad and guilty later, or even in the moment, or you refuse to acknowledge them and pretend that they never happened. But all these things are learning experiences from which you can and do grow, so accept your limitations, they are part of the illusion. Forgive yourselves quickly for your mistakes, and honor yourselves for the lessons that you have learned and for forgiving and loving yourselves. Unless you treat yourselves well, you will be unable to treat others well, because what you do to yourselves is what you do to others. So to treat yourselves well creates a win-win situation and automatically extends your powerfully loving energy fields outwards to interact harmoniously with the energy fields of others. People then feel good around you, and you, of course, then feel good around them. With energy like that flowing, the information necessary to resolve issues and problems arises easily and quickly. You have what it takes to assist in humanity's awakening process, that is why you are on Earth at this momentous time. Do not be discouraged when you feel tired or depressed. Go within, ask us, your loving guides and mentors, for assistance and a loving hug to raise your spirits. Then, suitably refreshed, reconfirm your intent to be loving in every situation and continue to awaken humanity. You are making it happen. With so very much love,